सो हाई गाइज, वेलकम बैक वंस अगेन टू द सेशन ऑफ PIB 247. मैं हूं मनीष मिश्रा एंड गाइज, इन टुडे सेशन वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस सम मोर क्वेश्चंस फ्रॉम द PIB न्यूज विच आर इम्पोर्टेंट फॉर द ESI सेक्शन ऑफ RBI ग्रेड बी. सो लेट्स बिगिन विद द सेशन गाइज, बट बिफोर वी बिगिन, इफ यू आर न्यू हियर, डू सब्सक्राइब टू आवर चैनल एंड प्रेस दिस बेल आइकन. ओके, एंड यू कैन ऑल्सो जॉइन दिस टेलीग्राम ग्रुप फॉर डेली क्विजेस एंड अपडेटेड इन्फॉर्मेशन अबाउट द डेली सेशंस. ओके, और इसका जो लिंक है यू विल गेट इन द डिस्क्रिप्शन. So let's begin with the very first question of the day. Which of the following app has been launched by the Department of Post and India Post Payment Bank to provide digital financial inclusion? Digital financial inclusion provide कराने के लिए, उसको promote करने के लिए, one app has been launched by the Department of Post and the India Post Payment Bank. So you just have to tell the name of that app. Okay. So guys, the name of the app is what? DarkPay. You can see here. What is the name of the app? DarkPay, and these are the services that you can avail from the app. For example, you can transfer your money domestically, scan QR code and transfer money to the merchants. Then enabling cash ecosystem through the biometrics is also one of the function of this app. And providing interoperable banking services to the customers of any bank. Kisi dusre bank ke saath bhi interoperable services will be provided through this app, which is known as DarkPay, and it has been launched by Department of Post and India Post Payment Bank. Alright. So that's it about this news, guys. And therefore, here the correct answer should be what? Option A, DarkPay. And this question, guys, can be asked in the one marker of ESI section of RBI Grade B. And now moving on to the next question. Which of the following Department of Government of India has instituted the Meghdoot Award? Meghdoot Award has recently been given by one of the departments, so you have to tell the name of the department. Okay, so guys, this department is the Department of Post. Okay, Department of Post has given this award, which is known as Meghdoot Awards, in various categories for excellence in the postal services. Postal services mein jo bhi person ne excellence kiya hai, unko ye award diya jata hai, jiska naam hai Meghdoot Awards. And this year, it has been given by the Department of Post. In fact, every year, it is given by Department of Post. Okay. And these are some awards categories and their winners. Guys, there are various categories and various winners. But these three are the most important. You just have to remember these three categories and the winners of these categories. Okay. First of all, we have general category for Grameen Dak Sevak. It's Kirtan Nayak. Then we have technology excellence category. In that category, the winner is VM Shakti Velu. And the best woman employee was given to Rin Chen. Okay, so these are the three most important categories and their winners. You just have to remember these three categories only. Okay, and talking about other things, so during guys this award ceremony, there was some other initiative that has also been taken by the Department of Post. Like there is an MOU that has been signed between the Department of Post and CSC e-governance services India Limited. And why this MOU has been signed? So this MOU has been signed for setting up of common services center in more than 10,000 post office across the country. And through this common services center, all the government to citizen and business to citizen services will be provided to the citizens which are in the rural areas or in the remote areas of the country. ठीक है, हमारे देश के जो rural और remote areas हैं, वहाँ पे government की और government to citizen और business to citizen services पहुँचाने के लिए this MOU has been signed. और इसके through क्या होगा? सीएससी सेंटर्स बनाए जाएंगे इन मोर देन 10,000 पोस्ट ऑफिसेस अक्रॉस द कंट्री. ओके, एंड देयर वाज वन ई बुक दैट वाज लॉन्च व्हिच इज नेम्ड एज इंडिया पोस्ट मीट्स COVID-19 चैलेंज. ओके, दिस बुक वाज आल्सो लॉन्च्ड ड्यूरिंग द इवेंट ऑफ मेघदूत अवार्ड्स. ऑलराइट, सो गाइस दैट्स इट अबाउट दिस न्यूज. एंड व्हाट वाज द क्वेश्चन? व्हिच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग डिपार्टमेंट हैज इंस्टीट्यूटेड दीज अवार्ड्स? सो गाइस, इट्स डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ पोस्ट. ऑप्शन बी, डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ पोस्ट विल बी द करेक्ट आंसर. And now let's move on to question number 3. So guys, question number 3 and 4 both are based on electricity market report. So let's talk about this report first, then we'll move on to the question number 3 and 4. So electricity market report, this is the first ever electricity market report 2020, and it has been launched by International Energy Agency. International Energy Agency has released this report. So you have to tell me the headquarter of International Energy Agency. Maine aapko kai baar bataya hai. And this report, guys, assesses the 2020 trends and 2021 forecast related to the electricity demand, supply, capacity and emission. Electricity ki demand, uski supply, uski capacity, uski emission ka kya trend raha hai 2020 mein aur 2021 mein kya forecast hongi, uske baare mein ye report assessment deta hai. Okay. And talking about the trends in 2020, so according to this report, ग्लोबल इलेक्ट्रिसिटी डिमांड इज एक्सपेक्टेड टू फॉल बाय 2% इन द ईयर 2020 एंड गाइस दिस कॉन्ट्रैक्शन इज ड्यू टू द COVID-19 एंड इट्स इकोनॉमिक इंपैक्ट. ओके, COVID-19 और उसके जो इकोनॉमिक इंपैक्ट है उसकी वजह से दिस इलेक्ट्रिसिटी डिमांड इज एक्सपेक्टेड टू फॉल बाय 2%. ऑलराइट, एंड चाइना विल बी द ओनली मेजर इकोनॉमी टू सी हायर इलेक्ट्रिसिटी डिमांड इन 2020. लेकिन एक ही एक्सेप्शन है इसमें, ये जो इलेक्ट्रिसिटी डिमांड गिर रही है बाय 2%, देयर इज एन एक्सेप्शन. चाइना एक अकेली ऐसी मेजर इकोनॉमी है जहां पे इलेक्ट्रिसिटी डिमांड इंक्रीज होगी. इनफैक्ट इन इंडिया ऑल्सो द इलेक्ट्रिसिटी डिमांड विल फॉल बाय सर्टेन परसेंटेज विच इज ऑल्सो अप्रोक्सीमेटली 2%. ओके, एंड रिन्यूएबल इलेक्ट्रिसिटी जनरेशन विल एक्सपेक्टेड टू ग्रो बाय 7% इन 2020 एंड दिस इज ड्यू टू गाइज All the government, all the countries are focusing on renewable energy production. So that is why renewable energy electricity generation will expected to grow by 7% in the year 2020. Carbon dioxide emission caused due to electricity generation is expected to fall by 5% in the year 2020. Carbon dioxide ke jo emission hai wo kam ho jayenge by 5% in the year 2020. And wholesale electricity prices have also declined in 2020. That is due to less demand and the lower fuel prices and more production of renewable energy. Okay, so that is the trends in 2020. And now let's talk about the forecast for the year 2021. So after the recovery of the global economy, the global electricity demand is expected to rise by 3%. जो हमारे पूरी दुनिया में global electricity demand है वो बढ़ जाएगी by 3%, जो कि अभी 2020 में कम हुई है by 2%. Okay. And production of renewable energy will grow more in 2021, but the coal is expected to bounce back, which was lagging in the year 2020. 2020 में याद रखना आपको that the electricity production due to coal is expected to fall by 5%. Okay, while it will bounce back in the year 2021, and electricity output from wind and solar PV will expand their market share to 29% in the year 2021. Wind energy और solar PV की वजह से जो energy generate होती है उसके जो मार्केट शेयर है दैट विल इंक्रीज टू 29% इन द ईयर 2020. इट्स 2021 गाइस. ओके, इट इज 2021. एंड नाउ टॉकिंग अबाउट इंडिया स्पेसिफिक डेटा, सो इंडिया इलेक्ट्रिसिटी डिमांड इज ऑल्सो एक्सपेक्टेड टू फॉल बाय 2% इन द ईयर 2020. 2020 में इंडिया में भी जो इलेक्ट्रिसिटी की डिमांड है वो कम हो जाएगी बाय 2020. एंड इन द मार्च 2020 अकॉर्डिंग टू दिस रिपोर्ट the electricity demand fell by 28% due to the nationwide lockdown. जो lockdown हुआ था सबको याद होगा, उसकी वजह से मार्च में इंडिया में इलेक्ट्रिसिटी की जो डिमांड थी that fell by 28%. And coal dominated the electricity production in India. हमारे देश में जितना भी इलेक्ट्रिसिटी प्रोडक्शन है 2020 का, उसका 55% जो शेयर है वो कोल की वजह से कोल से जो इलेक्ट्रिसिटी प्रोड्यूस होती है उसका है. ओके, इन 55% ऑफ द टोटल प्रोडक्शन ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिसिटी कोल वाज यूज्ड. ऑलराइट, सो दैट्स इट अबाउट दिस रिपोर्ट. एंड नाउ लेट्स मूव ऑन टू क्वेश्चन नंबर 3 and 4. सो व्हाट इज क्वेश्चन नंबर 3? व्हिच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग एजेंसीज हैज रिलीज्ड द फर्स्ट एवर इलेक्ट्रिसिटी मार्केट रिपोर्ट 2020? सो गाइस, दिस एजेंसी इज व्हाट? इंटरनेशनल एनर्जी एजेंसी. ऑप्शन बी इज द करेक्ट आंसर. क्वेश्चन नंबर 4 इज, यू हैव टू फाइंड द करेक्ट स्टेटमेंट रिगार्डिंग दिस रिपोर्ट, इलेक्ट्रिसिटी मार्केट रिपोर्ट 2020. So let's talk about these statements. Global electricity demand is expected to fall by 3% in 2020. So guys, is it 3%? No, it is 2%, which means this statement is incorrect. Global electricity demand is expected to grow by 2% in 2021. That is not 2%, that is 3%, which means this statement is also incorrect. And in March 2020, in India, electricity demand fell by 38%. That is again not 38%, that's 28%, which means all the three statements are incorrect. Therefore, option D, none is correct, will be the correct answer. And now guys, let's move on to question number 5, which is the last question for today. During the recently conducted national webinar of Kamdhenu Chair in Universities and College, it was decided to set up a Kamdhenu Chair in all the universities and colleges. So the question is, what is the objective of this chair? So guys, let's talk about this news. So this superb idea of setting up of Kamdhenu chair has been given by Dr. Vallabhbhai Kathiria, who is the chairperson of Kamdhenu Aayog. And the objective of the chair will be to bring forth the science related to the indigenous cows. जो हमारे देश की indigenous cows हैं, उनके पीछे जो science है, उसको बाहर निकालना इस chair का objective है. So आप सबने सुना होगा that गाय हमारी माता है और हमको कुछ नहीं आता है. And government is trying to prove this. Now let's come back to the question. What is the objective of this chair? To bring forth the science related to indigenous cows. Option C will be the correct answer. So guys, that's it for the session. I hope all the questions are clear, and if you have any doubts, you can ask me in the comment section. Thank you so much for watching. Milte kal ke session mein. Goodbye, take care, and God bless.